What is going on, everyone? It is Mike, and welcome back to Tech 24/7 TV. Today is May 6th, right? Wednesday, May 6th. I just received an update for release version of the update for the Brydge keyboard. Very simple process. You go ahead and basically install the app, plug your keyboard into power, and after maybe 45 seconds, the keyboard is updated. I received a few comments in the video saying, you know, maybe I was going a little bit too hard on Brydge, or maybe I didn't go investigate, you know, deeply enough to go ahead and figure out how it works. And here's my perspective on that. So you're viewing this video based on whether or not this keyboard is gonna be something you wanna go ahead and consider buying. I mean, at $200 or $230, it's not an insignificant amount of money. Well, if I was kind of just glossed over some of the problems that I had, it would really be doing a disservice to you. And I really couldn't recommend this in good conscience because it wouldn't be something that I would, you know, consider myself. So at the end of the day, you have to think about, you know, how am I gonna evaluate this product? I mean, as a keyboard, I think this is a great product. I've liked all the other Brydge keyboards, and this Brydge Pro Plus keyboard is no different. It's got the wonderful, as I like to think of them, iOS function keys that provide me a lot of utility, and I imagine they provide a lot of other people utility as well. That's why they're so popular. The keyboard experience is absolutely different than the Magic Keyboard, which makes sense. That Magic Keyboard is $100 or $150 more expensive than this. Again, depending on which iPad you have and, you know, where you're moving up. Is this a bad typing experience? Absolutely not. The typing experience, I think, is sufficient for a majority of people. There might be some people who don't like this typing experience and they prefer the scissor switches on the Magic Keyboard, but that doesn't mean that this typing experience is bad. You know, the other perspective that you gotta view this from is, how is the trackpad? Now, I have the most recent version of iPadOS beta. I also have the Brydge software update, which came maybe an hour ago. I went through the process of, you know, turning it off, unregistering it, or deleting it from my Bluetooth profile, then pulling it back on, and then pairing it back on, not putting it back on. But I would say, again, some things work better than they did previously. Some things haven't changed, and that might just be an iterative process. I still have that weird issue that when I plug it into power, the keyboard, if I'm looking at the battery indicator inside of the battery widget, jumps to 100, and as soon as I unplug it, it precipitously drops at like 1% per minute, I think down to 75. That's where the bottom floor where I've seen it kind of hover around, which is, I think, is kind of strange because I really don't know if it's charged, but who knows, maybe it doesn't matter because it's 3-month battery life. And between now and 3 months, we'll have several updates. I don't know that for a fact, but it certainly could be. But let me know if you've actually seen that with your Brydge keyboard, because that would be, bro, maybe my keyboard's broken. I'm just the odd man out here. So at the end of the day, you really have to ask yourself, are you comfortable with a level of inconsistency that you might receive from another product? Is it a bad product? No. Is it consistently work like, you know, again, the Magic Keyboard, the Magic Trackpad, or even the Logitech Combo Touch? No, it doesn't. But if I have no point of reference for those other products, you know, you might never know that. So that being said, as long as you can manage your expectations and, you know that Brydge will continually work over time to deliver software upgrades and change the functionality, right, for hopefully for better, that this should be a decent experience. For myself, I would say that I could not recommend this to someone who I know is a, you know, someone who's a power user, someone who's been using the Magic Keyboard for some period of time, someone who, you know, comes from Mac and uses a Magic Trackpad, because it is different. There's no doubt about that. But that may or it may not be okay with you. Only you would be able to tell me that. And, you know, why don't you go ahead and let me know in the comments below. But otherwise, I think at this point, I'm going to keep the Brydge Pro Plus simply as a point of reference. As moving forward, as Brydge continues to work on these updates for this keyboard, and as the Magic Keyboard continues to evolve, we might see different functionality delivered to each of these products that hopefully change them for the better, right? I mean, that's all that we're, you know, we can hope for as consumers. Excuse my kid, he's screaming in the pool right now. That's all we can hope for as consumers, is that these companies like Brydge, like Apple, Logitech, continually work to make their products better over time, and that software will push the envelope forward, again, making for a better experience. I would love to know what your experience is with the Brydge Pro Plus in the comments below. I have some other videos planned in terms of review, kind of comparisons against the Brydge Pro Plus, the Logitech Slim Folio Pro, the Magic Keyboard as well, in addition to the, what does Apple call their other keyboard? The Slim Folio, no, Slim Folio Pro? In addition to the Apple Keyboard Folio, let me know which one you would wanna see down in the comments below. I am Mike, this is Tech 24/7 TV. Stay safe out there.